So in this problem, we're assuming that for every $2 spent on advertising, a business sees $3 increase in sales. We want to know what the relationship is between the change in money spent on advertising and the change in received sales. Because our input is going to be the amount spent on advertising, our output is going to be how much we get into sales, and then see if we can generalize this into some kind of formula. So, let's take a look. Let's start by building a table. Let's assume that if the company spends nothing on advertising, they get $5 in sales. All right. Well, let's think about how they get up to $8 in sales. If we increase the advertising cost by $2, then we would expect our sales to increase by $3, because for every $2 spent in advertising, their sales increase by $3. But what if they only increase their advertising by $1? How much would their sales go up by? Well, their sales would be 6.5 because their advertising went up by $1. So their sales went up by 0.75, or $1.5. So for every $1 increase in advertising, their sales are going to go up by 1.5. Right. Similarly, what if we went up to $8? What if we increased $8 in advertising? Well, that $1 in advertising times 8 gives us an $8 increase. So what are we going to be multiplying by 8 over here? Well, remember that for every $1 in advertising, it was 0.75 in sales. So 0.75 times 8 gives us the change between 5 and 17, because 0.75 times 8 is 12. Adding that to the 5 gives us the 17, which gives us our total sales. Okay. So we can do the same thing to get what happens when we spend $9.50 on advertising. We started off with 0, and we increased our advertising cost by 9.5. Similarly, we started at 5 in sales, and then we increased by 9.5, and then we multiply that by 0.75 because that's our constant rate of change. So now, let's take a look at what we have here. We have a proportional relationship between the change in sales and the change in advertising costs. It's always going to be 0.75. That's what gives us this linear graph. No matter what advertising price we pick and what sales price we pick, if we look at the ratio of the change in advertising and the change in sales, we are going to get 0.75. Now, to generalize, suppose that if the business spends nothing on advertising, it has $W in sales. Okay, so W could be any amount. We used 5 last time. Well, now our table is going to look like this. So for $1 increase in advertising is W plus 0.75. For 2, it's W plus 0.75 times 2. For N dollars spent in advertising, it's W plus 0.75 times N. So in function notation, we might write S of N equals W plus 0.75 N. In this case, the slope, which is 0.75, represents that change. It's that constant change in advertising, constant change in sales with respect to advertising, which in this case is 0.75.